So in today's video, I'm going to show you how you can go ahead and connect YouTube into OBS. That way you can begin streaming over to YouTube. And I'm going to share with you also the best settings. That way your YouTube stream does not lag. So let's go ahead and jump into OBS to go ahead and get this all set up. So once you have OBS open, what you're going to want to do is on the right hand side, you're going to want to come to where it says settings. Once you select that, it's going to bring you over here to a new menu. You're going to want to select stream, and by default, it's going to be on custom. What you're going to want to do is you're going to want to select the YouTube RTMPS. Now it's going to go ahead and give you two options here. It's going to allow you to connect your account directly to YouTube or to utilize a stream key. And today I'm going to show you how to utilize both those options. So the first thing we can do is the recommended route, which is to just directly connect your account. It's going to go ahead and prompt you over to sign in to your Google accounts you utilize for your YouTube channel. So I'll go ahead and select the email that I have selected here for my YouTube channel. And then it's going to go ahead and prompt you to go ahead and get logged in to get everything authorized. And it's going to go ahead and ask you to give permission to OBS to be able to access your YouTube channel. So you'll simply select continue. And then you'll see here it says authorization complete successfully. You can now close this page. So we'll go ahead and close that there. We'll come back to OBS and you'll see here that now we're 100% connected over to YouTube. So if right now you selected start streaming, you would push that over to your YouTube channel. But before you hit that start stream, we want to make sure that your settings are right. So that way the quality on YouTube is good. So you can see here that it says the maximum video bit rate is 51,000 for YouTube. Now I found the sweet spot for the settings to give me the best quality without making my machine go crazy or my CPU usage be too high. So on the left hand side, you're going to select output. You're going to want to ahead and copy the settings that I have here, okay, especially if your internet can support it. So the output mode, you're going to select advanced. Encoder, you're going to select x264. For the rate control, you're going to select CBR. And for the bit rate, you're going to select 9000. Now, this is going to be super important. You're going to want to do a speed test. So you can go to speedtest.net. I'll put a link in the description for you to access that website to be able to test your internet. If your upload speed is above 10 or 15 or 20, you can go ahead and utilize the bit rate that I have here. And then for your key vault interval, you're going to put 2. CPU usage, you're going to do very fast, profile high, and then tune serial latency. Then you can simply select apply and you'll select OK. And now what you want to do is you want to go ahead and start streaming. Now, if your stream is lagging when you actually do that, I went ahead and created a video going deeper into settings in OBS that you can set up to make sure that your stream doesn't lag. I'll put the link for that video in the description of this video here. Now, I wanted to show you the other way for you to be able to connect YouTube to OBS, which is utilizing the stream key feature. So we're just going to disconnect our account here and we'll select use stream key. Now, this is a great way to be able to utilize well if you don't want to connect your YouTube channel directly into OBS. It's recommended because you get access to the chat and you can manage things a little bit better when you use the recommended route. But however, I wanted to show you this other option. So you come back to your YouTube channel. Here, you're going to select the little camera icon. You're going to select create. And you're going to select go live. This is now going to go ahead and bring you over to the YouTube Creator Studio for us to be able to go ahead and get our stream key that we can go ahead and provide over into OBS to go ahead and get everything set up. So once you have this open here, you're going to see three options: stream, webcam, or manage. You're going to select stream, and once you do that, that's going to bring you over to here to the dashboard for that actual stream. So again, you'll select stream. It's going to say if I want to schedule a stream. Now you can do that as well if you want to, but we're going to select the stream icon here. And what we're going to see here is going to say stream key. Now it's very important that you don't share the stream key with anyone, because anyone who has access to the stream key is going to be able to go ahead and stream on your behalf and on your account. So we'll simply select copy. Okay, and once you select copy, you're going to come back into OBS and you're simply going to go ahead and paste that. And then you can simply go ahead and connect account, right? So once you've done that, you can now go ahead and select here, use stream key. You have the stream key applied there. You simply select apply. You say okay. And now when you hit start streaming, that's going to push it over. But I highly recommend that you utilize the recommended route. Now, I have the ultimate streamer checklist that is super important for you to be able to know, where I talk about the things you should do before you go live, the things to do during your live stream, and what to do after your live stream. So that way you can stop guessing on what it is you need to do to be able to grow. This checklist is going to give you everything that you need and it's completely free. So go in the description of this video and click the link to be able to download the ultimate guide stream or checklist that you're going to have side by side. It's going to allow you to be able to succeed. But now that you have your YouTube connected directly into OBS, how do you go ahead and make your stream look professional? So I went ahead and created a video that I want you to click right here, where I walk you step by step on setting up overlays inside of OBS. And I even give you free overlays you can download to make your stream look professional. Go ahead and click that video right there to watch that now. See you guys in the next video.